This is Dr. William Pollack. I'm discussing osteopenia and osteoporosis today. These two conditions are very common in women entering menopause and after menopause. They actually begin in a woman's 40s. Hormones are declining in perimenopause and menopause due to declines in estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone. All of these are responsible for maintaining bone density. Osteoclasts are the bone-breaking molecules, and osteoblasts are the bone-building molecules. They have to be in balance. Hormones maintain the production and development of osteoblasts, and when that begins to shift, then the osteoclasts take over and break down bone. This involves all the bones in the body. That means that bone density decreases with age. It happens all the time. It's continuous. The risk in developing osteopenia and osteoporosis is that you will develop fractures. And that we definitely want to avoid that because fractures can become very disabling. Now, medications are used for this by many doctors, but what happens, unfortunately, is that these medications cause lots of problems on their own, including messing with the immune system. Pulsed electromagnetic fields actually do a much better job of building bone. And they actually support the bone in ways that hormones do. And you need at least 30 Gauss to do this job, and preferably a whole body system because it involves the entire skeleton. Treatment should be every day, at least half an hour to an hour every single day, usually for the rest of a woman's life, to maintain the bone density. But you also need bone building tools. These bone building tools include calcium, vitamin D, and so on. I have a list of these in a report, a free report that's available to you by contacting drpollack.com. info@drpollack.com or calling us. All the best.